Mr. Mehra has been dealing with petroleum products trade. I relate to him with ships and tanks and movement of products across India. Bharat Petroleum is a leader in technology and trades from Indian context. We have been on this scouting run for energy sources for long, both crude oil, gas, coal, and other sources. But we are extremely rich on our refining capabilities, and that puts second question to us as to, under the circumstances that we are refinery surplus, crude oil prices are tumbling like anything, what will happen to the products and where will India be, Mr. Mehra?
Thank you. Just to give a few perspectives, and to just what Mr. Doshi also said, is I would also like to add that when we were in school and college, that time we always used to listen to the story that whatever is left will last only for 25 years. So the story which we heard that time, and more than three decades have passed, but going by the present reserves, oil is going to be there for at least next 45 years with existing reserves and existing rate of consumption. And I find that every year that number goes up. So world is currently, it is overflowing with oil. And that is perhaps what we see during the last 6 to 8 months, why the prices have gone down. It is again overflowing of oil, plus with other factors. Even the recent time, the very tense geopolitical situations could also not drive the oil prices to go up or shoot up. Even during the worst of time, about 6 months back, the oil prices were really falling during the intense fighting going on. So that is it's a phenomenon which shows that if the oil is surplus in the world, then it cannot sustain very high prices. There were other factors also driving this falling of prices, maybe the Dodd-Frank Act, which became more stringent, which made the people who are in commodities trading a little more stringent to keep the record. And many of the big players got out of it, and that used to keep the prices up. And also Iraq restoration and Libya restoration. And it is suspected that Iran oil is also finding, notwithstanding the sanction, it's leaking into the market. So with that background, the oil prices maybe is again rising, but it cannot get back to the peak which it was in the past. Plenty of oil is there, I think that is one aspect of it. But parallelly what is happening, many of the large countries, all the major energy consumption centers, like India is now actually ranking fourth after US, China, Japan, in terms of hydrocarbon energy consumption, or you can even say from primary energy consumption. They are also focusing on renewables. In sense, whether it is bioenergy, or whether it is in terms of solar or wind, there has been a renewed focus. As somebody mentioned about the Spanish experience, I also seen that. It's a huge hundreds of miles of solar panels put up, and maybe producing the major quantity of solar energy, but that can also happen in a country like India where there is no dearth of wind or sun. So this perhaps is contributing towards this lowering of prices. Has anybody quantified that? What is the delta which is building up now because of these renewables? In terms of biofuels, okay, we had a very checkered policy, kabhi haan, kabhi na, you know, sometimes yes, sometimes no. I was myself very actively involved in the Brazil project, where I went 9 to 10 times, so that we could be shortlisted the parties also, who will, we did the due diligence and all, but then suddenly somebody said, no, we should not invest abroad, as it will impact the profitability of sugar industries here in India. But nevertheless, somebody else did that project later on. But the countries like which have done good work in terms of bioenergy or biofuel is, I would say, Brazil has done number one. Maybe US, maybe Thailand, maybe Ghana, maybe to some extent China, and European, particularly on biodiesel. But I would say our performance has been It has been a very checkered performance, or it is a very intermittent, like biofuels also we talked about implementing 5% across. But we were, you know, sometimes we start, sometimes we stop. There's always conflicts going on, whether sugar industry is not giving us the ethanol or and oil companies are not buying it. So this story goes on. But here, I would say that we have also integrated energy policy. That policy speaks of, you know, dependence on so many energy or making ourselves independent. I would suggest here, let every district become, it's called, it's some sort of micro energy management, whereby every district thinks of, the district collector thinks of energy independence. Why take it to that scale? Why import energy from over? Let whatever possible you can do in terms of whether it's bioenergy or biogas or so many things he can do. Let him think of his KRA should include energy independence, what he has done in terms of achieving energy independence for his district. We are talking about smart cities. So are the smart cities going to be developed on some sort of a smart energy where they don't have to import much of the energy and it is generating all its energy within? I think these are some of the basic questions if we have to address our energy independence. Oil is going to be plenty. I don't think oil is going to get over anything in our lifetime, and I would say next generation's lifetime also. Coming back to what Deepak has said, see, we are in 1998, we were 60 million of our refining capacity, and today we are almost touching 230 million tons. Whatever target was there for the 11th plan, those targets were almost achieved, and we are also going to achieve the 12th plan period of being about 307 million tons. The new refining capacities are not being added. It is more driven by, at least for this sector oil company, is more driven by meeting the motor spirit and diesel requirement. And the private sector refineries have a different model in terms of exporting and all those things. So as such, we are, and moreover, also one should understand what's happening globally. Globally, many of the majors have closed down the refineries. Either closed down or they have scaled down the operations, primarily because they were outdated refineries. Whatever refineries has come in India and China, they are new generation refineries with much higher Nielsen index and all those things. So it is sort of a replacement to some of the international refineries which have closed down or scaled down their activities. And Shell also, I was very intensely dealing with Shell. They also, as a strategy, they were moving towards upstream activities more. I interacted with some people in London also. So that was a part of a strategy, and they also scaled down many of the refineries in Europe and Australia and other places. So this also we should see. India has become a refining hub. It was an opportunity we came the way, and we grabbed it, and we delivered it. So I don't feel any problem in me setting up the new refineries. We still have a very healthy rate of growth in terms of motor spirit and HSD, which are the two major products, and LPG, which is also driving by, today still, like I, as a company, I'm short of MSHSD. I have to buy from Reliance or whatever it is. Reliance is always first shortage on exports. So, I mean, this is, you know, how the game is going on. So, I don't see any problem, and India should be achieving its refining target of 307 million tons. At the end of the 12-year plan. I don't see, this question is always raised, the why we are setting up new refineries, various forums. But India is still, other big opportunities are per capita is the lowest, as somebody has displayed the figure. We are far away from US, China is still okay, three times more than, but Japan and all. And our mindset of our people are changing. Their lifestyles are changing. Everybody wants a car. First it was family, now every member of the family wants a separate car. And the demand of expensive cars are there, not only in major urban centers, but also in smaller towns, big cities or rural areas. One has to go and see how people's mindset has changed from buying gold and keeping it in the locker to buying cars and flashy mobiles, etc. Thank you.